We are in the Heritage Month,
and yes,
we are celebrating Ghana. Mm-hmm. We are talking, you know, and doing everything Ghana.
Yeah, definitely. Now, we want to learn about the history of Ghana. We want to learn about our culture. Perhaps you watching us, you want to know exactly where you come from. Mm-hmm. You can do that just by mention of your name. We have a fantastic historian who's joining us on set. His name is Kwaku Dako Ankra. And of course, he's going to treat us through some amazing historical background to the various names that you and I carry. Mm. Ladies and gentlemen, if you're ready, I am ready. Let's welcome Kwaku Dako Ankra.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Kwaku, welcome to the Outside Our Show.
Yeah, I like your smoke.
Yeah,
you know, anytime.
This one is a batakari or smoke.
Yeah, so we call it smoke in English. And the beautiful thing is the beauty or the unity of our dress today.
Mm-hmm.
This is North meets South.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
And it is a reflection of our collective cultural representation.
That's right.
So when we talk about the Akans,
mm-hmm.
the Kente is the our cloth, and also the if good Volta region, mm-hmm. Agutime people, they also make Kente.
Like I am just Dada like today.
And you look at the gold and then the beads, mm-hmm. the guns, the Damways, they also perform. They are the great makers of the beads.
It's funny he mentioned that Agutime, because you and I were in Agutime.
Yeah, we're in Agutime. Yes, 2020. Yes, we saw some
of the Agutime themselves, they are originally Damway people who went to settle there.
Yeah. Okay, so let's go to Ghana. Let's go to maybe before we gain independence, the story, you know, of our independence. Now, I want you to tell us how it's supposed to be, apart from how the colonial masters documented.
Okay, so most of the story that has not been told is about the way we lived as people. What is the Gold Coast of Africa before the coming of the Europeans?
Yeah.
Right.
What were our indigenous structures that we have before the white people came, or what we call the state formation, where the states were trying to expand or trying to become an ethnic group? In fact, if you look at the issue of the state formation, some coincided with European colonization. So at that time, when the Portuguese landed in Yabio in 1471, before the subsequent one in 1472 in Elmina.
Slow down.
Later, the building of the Elmina Castle in 1482.
Yeah.
That commenced the Portuguese attempt. Then afterwards, the coming of the Spanish, which did not secure much land. Then you have the Dutch coming in. Then you have the Swedes, the Sweden people were so here. The Sweden built Cape Coast Castle. After them, you have the Danes. Even the French people were here. Then you have the British finally coming in. So this is how it was.
So what, the British came in last?
They came in the last.
However, they dominated everybody else.
Because they had a clear agenda to colonize.
Okay.
So that is the difference. All the rest of them, there were engagements. They made an attempt. It was what I would call trade relations.
Okay.
So they didn't have a clear mandate of ruling over the people. Now, we were talking about the Africa before colonization. What then do we have, our way of life and so on? One of the most important, as written by J.E. Kesley Hayford in his Gold Coast Native Institution, he talks about a very established bureaucratic governance system that we have. Look at the Ashanti chieftaincy system. Look at the Ga formation from the old Ayawaso kingdom of the Ga people and how they have that organized system of governance. We have a king, we have divisions of labor. It was so wonderful. And even if you go through the Ashanti system, it evolved over the years. There was a time they created the new offices, office of trusteeship, office of treasury, and what have you, which was done by Ashanti, Osei Kodjo, which is called the Kwajuan Revolution, when he introduced this Europeanized form of governance. These were done before the incursion of the British into the Ashanti Kingdom. If you look at the coastal community, as you ask, the Gans are the most multi-ethnic of all the Ghanaian ethnic group in terms of cultural interaction. They have opportunity of meeting the Guans. And then their language evolving with the Obutu, language.
But the Gwons are everywhere.
Yes, because they are the aboriginals.
Okay.
They were
okay.
here. The Fantis came to meet them.
Okay.
The Gwons the Fantis came to meet were called Eti. Okay. The Eti people. So Anomabo as a place is an Eti before the Fantis.
So these are the Fantis that moved from present day
BA from Techiman before they came to coast. Mm. And then they met them at Mankesim. The Mankesim settlement used to be called Adwejil. Until the chief of the Etis was defeated, Nana Akram, and then the Fantis took over, renamed the settlement Mankesim. That is the big town. Even in Accra, the chief fisherman of Accra, Abio Chilukwanda, his ancestors were Fantis that came to settle there. The name is Abio Chilukwanda, but he's given a Gam pronunciation.
Wow.
So you see that his great grandfather was the warrior who fought when the Dutch Accra and British Accra fought for autonomy, and he led. And so when he died, he was honored with that chief fisherman rule, as you see.
You know, so talking about names and how we are changing stuff, you know, let me just ask about my name. Maybe we are calling me something else instead of what I'm supposed to be called, Frema.
So Frema comes from Frenny, that is the male name. So every person called Awuku, his appellation is Awuku Frenny. Awuku Frenny was an Ikwapim king, one of the Ikwapim kings. So Frenny is he who has wealth, plenty, Frenny. So the feminine or the female version is Frema. Okay, so it means you who have wealth. So Frema Ototuo, okay, Frema Ototuo Kwapim. About to so he's the one who bought guns and went to war. So that was the name of Frema. He was a powerful queen in BA, and he bought the queen and helped the Ashantis to fight against the Germans. That is how he earned the appellation Ototuo Kwapim. You see, so that is where your Frema come from.
Right. For me, I think when I dropped, my dad looked at my face, saw my ears, and was like, "This guy, he doesn't deserve an English name." So they gave me Nana Tufuo Boateng.
So Tufuo means you are a Ghana, or Tufuo, one who bear guns and go to war. So it is what is called status name. It is a status or occupation within the military structure. So you bear the guns. So you are a Ghana. Okay. So the Boateng means he one whose help is upright.
Okay.
So it's an upright helper. That is why your appellation is Dasebre. One whom we thank and squat without we thank him and we are tired. Ya das ya bre. Dasebre. So you thank him and you will never end. So in English, straight translation is gracious one. Then because his help is upright, he is also Oti the head. He leads.
Right.
He leads. So that is Oti. And your Chiria, what's the other name? Is
Edunyami.
Yes.
So Edu itself comes from the name of God. Okay. So the Edu is a hero. Edu, he helps you to reach your destination.
Okay.
So Edu. And then Nyami is God. What is Nyami? The one when we get, we are satisfied. Nyami. So you see the understanding of how our forefathers understand the creator as the one when you have, you are satisfied. Winyana, mami.
So my name together,
so
tell me what
it means. So the appellation is a Triampum. That means the one when you rely upon, you will never fall down.
Wow.
When you so it means the dependable one. So that is where Edunyami Triampong came from in Asokware Mampong area. So the name exists around Asokware area, Fijiase.
My father comes from Fijiase.
Yeah, so that is it. So it is in that order.
Oh, okay. You are so
interesting.
Awesome.
Because I've traveled to all those community, and it has taken me almost 10 years now to put all the Akan names together wherever. And after that, I will do maybe the Gan ones, get all those things. Then we proceed on so that as a country, we get a very collective database of our names and understanding without borrowing from these Eurocentric names. We do not know its origin and influences on us.
A name like Ameniwa.
Ameniwa is from Ameni. The name. So whenever the accounts want to feminize the name. Okay. They add either wa or ba.
Okay.
So it's your name like a Yaniba. It doesn't go with Yaniwa.
Okay.
Okay. Or you answer. The fantasy say Ansaba.
Oh, baby Ansaba.
Yeah. Others also say Bia.
The Bia is the Kriapim.
Yeah.
The Kriapim add the Bia. So the Oparibia, Asaribia, Asabia, and so on. So that is how the. So the Ameni means a neighbor.
Oh, okay.
One you know.
The neighbor. So the people are looking for Ameni. It's nothing to.
Yeah. So you were Ameni Ampong, the great neighbor. Okay. Or that Ameniampong is a river in Kumasi. Kumasi
I attended Ameniampong secondary school.
Yeah.
In Mampong. So you're just
Okum Inta. That is the lion that kills in twos.
Oh wow.
So Ameniampong is a great name. Ameniampong, I had the Akrobujan in Tata.
Amazing.
The one who was taught to work with the rhythm of bullets. That is his appellation.
Wow.
So when we study our names, and even as I do the translation, it wows me.
Of course.
It wows
this is beautiful. And this is history and our culture. Yeah. Now, quickly before we let you go, you know, we have some historical images here.
Yeah.
What can you say about any of them?
Do you recognize any?
No, I've always...
Apart from the obvious, that's it, my chest.
I've always admired the work of Diogratis for a very long time. Sometimes I direct people because of J.B. Vanderpoel's work, as the earlier speaker talked about, is a pioneer. In fact, one of the people who have been able to, you know, curatize the work for a very long time, and they need to be, you know, praised.
Okay, but let's look at the day, the days of the week, the names that come with it. So, for instance, I am Abna.
Okay.
I'm
so, who am I?
So, the ancient accounts use the two, the planetary system. So they use five then known planets which they could see. You know, in the past they could sit, they could stand on Earth and see the planets. That is why Galileo, before him, Copernicus could see. And then when the telescope came, Kepler and co with Galileo could use it to see, because it was slow. Today you use telescope, you won't see. You need something else. So as the Earth grows, there is more distance between Earth and other bodies. That is because of the oscillatory system. Now the accounts at that time were seen, just as if you read the Bible in the book of Job, you will see how Job was also mentioning the planetary system, because he could see it at the time. So the accounts also also named their children with Jupiter, Mars, Venus, and then Saturn. Okay, in that order. Then they use the other two planetary systems, which is the sun and then the moon. So account day start with the Sunday. So let's start with the Sunday, which is a planet, which is the heavenly body, which is the sun. Sun, its appellation among the accounts was Esi. Okay. A sea, because it is the last realm, and if it is the last realm, it means it is the one that also begins with the week of the week. So the appellation is, so they call the name called a sea. Kwesi. You see, so the servant of the a sea, that is the word, the sun. So if you are Kwesi, you need to be the person is very, he shines, he glows everywhere he goes. So that is the meaning of Kwesi. And the female name is Akwesiwa or Kwesiwa, which is which we have pronounced over the year to Akosia. It is from Akosiwa. So the W has been removed, giving you the Akosia you have. The Fantis, and on the other hand, go straight with the AC. So the name become AC. So AC and Akosia means the same. So the Fantis prefer AC. Then the other tree speaking people prefer the Akosia. And in that order. So because it is a sun, it's a thing of beauty. That's why we say Akosia Bruni. Akosia Ababawa Nero Efe. So it has a beautiful skin. So if you look at AC people, they glow. And then the Kwesi is Obue Kwain. Kwesi, the one who is a trailblazer. Okay, so that is, then he's also Kwesi Bodia. So he is a whisk. Whisk, or as you hold, is a symbol of authority and symbol of leadership. So when you hold it, it means you lead a path and other people follow you.
All right. So let's touch on the other days.
So I'm going to the other one. So we go to Monday, which is the moon. So coming from the moon, which is Ajo. You know, moon bring calmness.
Okay.
Okay. So, Kwa Jo
Okay.
The servant of the cool one, Kwadjo. So okay. All the Kwadjos are very calm people. Mm. So that's why the appellation is Bajo.
Okay.
The child but who are, is
cool. So the Ajuas are also cool people.
Yes, the female one is Ajua.
Really?
Okay. The Ajua school.
So wait. So Ajua, wow. And the Fantis don't call it Ajua, they call it Araba.
Okay.
So Ajua and Araba.
Okay.
Now, you said not some of them are cool.
Yeah.
So you see moon, it moves round.
Yeah.
There are times the cloud come to the face of the moon and you don't see it until it goes.
Yeah.
That is where the mood swings come. Because the darkness have come to the brightness and it gives you the mood swing. So sometimes Kojo and Nessie can have some serious mood swings. This is the letter you come back again. So this is the nature from the Ajo. So don't be surprised when sometimes mood swings come to their way. It is the darkness that is passing through the brightness.
So now we'll understand that. So let's go to Tuesday.
Then you go to Tuesday, Bena. Bena, Venus is the planet of heat. Okay. So as a planet of heat, it is well cooked. So the Fantis call them Kobna Ebo. So the servant of the one who is a heat, so Kobna Ebo, it comes a time of plenty. It's like a fog. Kobna Ebo on in that order. And the female is what?
Abena.
Abena. Now Abena for you. That is the sorry, I said the man the is Ajua, isn't it? Fanti too is Ajua, but Araba is rather the Tuesday for the Kobna. So in that order.
So then if somebody Wednesday, is Tuesday, how do they behave? Because you mentioned the Ajuas, they are calm when the moon covers, the clouds cover the moon, then they have the moon swing. So how would you know somebody is Abena?
So the Bena is from someone who is well cooked.
Okay.
So it means it's somebody who can withstand a lot of things, he can move on. He is somebody to who is very sentimental because it's from Bena. No, Bena is a day that I can use to also wail. So sometimes they can be sentimental. When things pain them, they can cry in that order. Because you see the burning nature, make them feel pain, and then they cry. So they could be very, what is called, sentimental in the way they do things sometimes. But they also have that agility and strength and resilience. As
that
you
is
said.
Us.
Then you go to
Wednesday.
My own name, Kweku.
Ah, yes.
So it is a planet, Eku, which is Saturn.
Okay.
Saturn, the one with the ring around it. And because it is Saturn, Eku means the majestic one.
Okay.
A celebrated champion.
Yeah. Wow.
So you see Kweku, Kweku Atobi, Kweku Ntoni, Kweku Ntodi, he buys for you.
Okay.
Oh, okay.
So he will do things and decide for you because he's a majestic person.
Let's do Thursday.
But the female one is...
Before we go to Thursday, is there a relationship between Wednesday bonds and Satan? Because
it is Saturn. No, okay, that is very important question. Because of the day Kweku is born as Eku, okay, which is a planet, I did not say Saturn, it's Mercury rather.
Okay.
You see Mercury, when it's on the, it's on the floor, you can't touch it.
Yeah.
So it makes Kweku a genius.
Mm.
So it is difficult to predict him. So the Fantis, for instance, have an extended appellation for Kweku, which is Asementraba Kweku. The ancient rod.
Okay.
You see, so as an ancient rod of the ancestors, he is somebody you cannot predict. So he has become a genius who does certain things that is unpredictable. So people say Kweku Obilisi or Kweku Bansam, as you said. He did things that you wouldn't understand. So they crafted the Bansam, but it has never been part of Kweku's name as Bansam. It is rather Kweku Obilisi. The Bansam part is a modernist revision, stuff about Kweku.
Let's touch on
I take
talk
exceptions to that.
That.
Let's touch on Thursday, Friday,
so,
Saturday.
Yeah, because of the time. Yeah.
So Thursday is Yao. Okay. So that's what they call Awo. Awo. Okay. So it's from Daniel. So you see that the nation, they call them Aweya. That is how they call them. And it's as a pregnant mass at that time. What they also do is that the day is a day of pain. So that's what Yao. And there are people who can resist pain. And they can do things that will shock you. That's why we call them Yao Prekun.
Okay.
He does things. Relentless fighter. Immediately he will do it.
And we call the Mother Earth Yao.
Yes, the quality, yeah, because we believe that was the day the earth came into existence. So it is the earth's day. One who can withstand. Mm. And then Abba ya Bosu. Okay. Bosu, the Fantins call ya Abba. Mm. So every Abba is ya. And in some Fantin communities it's called Abba ya straight. So it's one who has come to withstand pain.
Great.
And he can do everything. And they are the most, the best cookies around, because that's why they say Abba ya jacha nukutu mumpambaruman. Okay, is Abba who sport is always filled with fresh scented kondo to prepare food.
Wow.
Again, Abba ya niyem Abba awo Abba diasa osanya nkofodi. So he's very fertile with about 30 children in her womb, and yet he takes care of other people's children.
Okay.
Let's do coffee.
Ya enkuma kesiya emufra enu mene nufra no. Okay, so he's a mighty okru, a giant okru or okru posse, which is the mighty wooden bone. In the olden days, they have wooden bone, children sit around it. So he's a okru posse. So it shows you there's a mighty pot whom children run sit around to eat, or he has a mighty breast which many children suckles.
Okay.
That is for ya. So very excellent name. The Fantin called the man not ya. They call it Kwao. So any equal you hear or quow, it's what? It's Thursday Yao. And it's quow, the strong one. It's Thursday, very genuine. You cannot push him anywhere. Quow, quow, quow. You see, that's the way he is. That's why we call him Quow Piramba, the intrepid. You cannot shake him off. That
Let's
is from
go
that.
To,
then
right,
go
Friday.
To the Friday is
the
Kofi.
They come and win.
So Kofi is a fee. Okay, that planet that moves because it is a fee.
Yeah.
Most of Kofi, they love to travel. That is why their appellation is Ochin. The one who roams, he roams. So many Kofi people love to travel. Look at President Kufuor, look at Kofi Annan, look at Kofi and they love to travel because they're from Efi. And it is in their nature that whatever they are looking for, wherever it is, they will travel and go and get it. That is why the fund is called Kofi Ochin. Ochin Ebu. Ebu Kofi Ayebi Ajay. So Ebu roams to do things and have created this. If you have performed your chores, sit down, don't go again. That is why they also called Kofi as a Kofi Baboni. Because in a Akan setup, Friday is a Fofida.
Yes.
Friday is a Fofida. A sacred day. A holiday, you need not to go anywhere. And you know, Bra Kofi, he travels. Or Ifua, he travels.
So Kofi Babani would definitely go.
So it is not that he was born. Kofi, you wanted that money. Kofi, who was born on that sacred day.
Yeah.
And people have watered down the meaning to as if Kofi is a bad child.
Right. We've run out of time.
Now, the last one is Saturday immediately. Yeah. So, Saturday is Kwame.
Yeah.
It's come from the planet Amin, which is the Saturn, which Amin is to prefer Elia. So, Amin means capable of swallowing everything.
Okay.
So, Kwame is also Kwame Atwapim. If you meet him, you meet thousands. Or Kwame Atuapoma, always ready to cock his gun to shoot, never ready shooter.
Yeah.
So that is why the Fantin cut it short. Ato. So when you hear Ato Kwame Na, you see that it be from the appellation which has been added to the name Kwame Na.
Awesome.
So it's from the Atuapoma.
Awesome.
And then the full appellation is Kwame Atuapim, Otenan Keduro. He is a snake bite herbalist, which makes him a leader, a sensationalist. He has charisma, everything he does. And the woman is Amma. The Fantis don't call it Amma, they call it Amba, A-M-B-A.
Okay.
And as Amba, he is Domina, mother of many people. So Amma people, they can show love and compassion.
It's rather unfortunate.
And then they are also agile, so they call them Amma Adoma. Adoma Yenten, Obeyi Yenten, Menu Baby Say.
So there's so much he has for us, so much
and
he wants to give us. It's unfortunate we do not have the time.
No wonder you are Kweku,
close to Bonsam.
Very unpredictable. You know, thank you very much, Kweku, for passing through.
We're so grateful.